Okay. So material additive process, what do you mean by material additive process? That we'll discuss just now, that is rapid prototyping. It is just one kind of product design and development process where we can develop small parts. And I'm just giving the overview of just before starting the RPT, just I wanted to give a brief introduction about the manufacturing processes. So there are two kind of processes normally we observed in the manufacturing area. So one is material removal process and the second one is material additive process. So material removal process, there are various material removal processes like conventional machining, non-conventional machining, traditional, non-traditional. Then material additive processes are like welding, brazing, and soldering. And the latest, this topic is, that is rapid prototyping. It is one kind of material additive process. So other manufacturing processes of metals are, that is casting and forming, machining, joining, and finishing. So in casting, normally it is mold and permanent mold. Forming and shaping, there are various processes like rolling, forging, extrusion, drawing, sheet metal forming, powder metallurgy, extrusion molding, all these comes under forming and shaping. Other machining processes are, that is turning, like simple conventional, you can see, that is turning, drilling, milling, shaping, broaching, grinding, all this. And joining processes, you can see. In machining also, there are two. One is conventional, non-conventional. Non-conventional, again, you can highlight, that is electrochemical machining, electro discharge machining, EDM, ECM, then ultrasonic machining, water jet machining, abrasive jet machining, like various we have. And joining another kind of manufacturing processes, that is welding, brazing, soldering, then diffusion bonding, adhesive bonding, and mechanical joining, including the RPT. And after that, the final manufacturing process is finishing. So that is simple, like we have to give the super finishing to the products, like honing, lapping, polishing, and burnishing, deburring. These are the various kind of techniques which we can use for the finishing process. Now, introduction, if you see this flowchart, material removal process, so we have two kind of various processes. One is traditional machining and non-traditional machining. Traditional, we can see, that is cutting, and another one is mechanical abrasion, where we can use kind of some kind of abrasives here. And cutting, if you expand, that is to get a circular shapes, we have to go for the turning, boring, drilling, these operations. If you want to go develop any various kind of shapes to the products, so other one are, that is milling, planing, shaping, broaching, gear forming, gear generating, all this. And mechanical abrasion, that is we have two kind of classifications in this: bonded abrasives and loose abrasives. In bonded abrasives, we can go for this grinding operation, then honing, and coated abrasives, we can use some kind of coating to the abrasives, like we are using in the machining. For the tools, we are using the coatings. Similarly, we can use the coated abrasives for the machining. And if you go for the loose abrasives, that is polishing, buffing, as these are the some classifications under loose abrasives for the mechanical abrasion. Non-traditional, you know, that is we have four kind of processes: chemical process, thermal, and chemical, photochemical, thermal, these processes. So those are, that is chemical machining. CHM stands for chemical machining. ECM is electrochemical machining, electrochemical grinding, electro discharge machining, laser beam machining, abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, plasma beam machining, ultrasonic machining. So these are the various, we can use different kind of various sources to develop the machining. And these are the, if you classify non-traditional machining, on mechanical processes are thermal process, chemical, and electrochemical. If you want to take the chemical, that is only photochemical machining, chemical machining. If you want to take only chemical help, electrochemical help, that is electrochemical machining. And under mechanical, we have, that is USM, ultrasonic machining, water jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, ion jet machining, and thermal process, electro discharge machining, electron beam machining, laser beam machining, ion beam, plasma beam. So these are the thermal related processes. So now just I'm going to the additive process here, rapid prototyping. So these are under these techniques, we have six kind of methods which we can develop the simple prototypes using the rapid prototyping technology. So first one is, that is FDM. It stands for FDM, that is fused deposition modeling. 3DP stands for 3D printing. Inkjet. LOM stands for laminated object manufacturing. then SLA, selective laser sintering, and stereolithography. SLA stands for stereolithography. SLS is stereo selective laser sintering. So these are the most common six techniques which we are using for the rapid prototyping. So the main thing is the input data is required as a CAD model, and you take the material and pour it into the RPT machine. It will scan by layer, you can generate a prototype. So here, that is main RPT. The objects can be formed with any geometric complexity without the need of for elaborate machine setup. So you can go any kind of complexity of the product. We can use with RPT. Like if you want to take any complex jobs, contour jobs, we can use with the help of CNC machining. If you want to go very geometric complexity products, we can approach the RPT. And the rapid prototyping system reduces the construction of complex objects. That is different RPT techniques are just now I highlighted. That is SLA stereolithography, fused deposition modeling, inkjet, three-dimensional printing, selective laser sintering, laminated object manufacturing, LMO. Okay, these are the techniques. This shows about the this is a circle which shows the input parameters, material parameters, applications, and method. This overall pictures of RPT, rapid prototyping, it covers under this circle diagram. That is input. What is the input needed to develop the rapid prototyping? What is the input material? It may be the CAD model, it may be the STL file, it may be the IGS file, any physical object, and cloud point, it is required. Minimum data should be, we have the either CAD model or surface model or solid model, or STL file, IGS, that is translators. And next, physical object. And the next is cloud pointer, digitizers. Through digitizer, you can scan the component, you get the cloud points, you can generate a CAD model, and then you can go for the RPT process. So this is the minimum input material is CAD model, STL, point data from digitizers, and the physical objects. Then the material, what kind of material we are using for the producing the RPT products. So the main materials are paper, resins, nylons, ABS, aquatine, butadiene, styrene, wax, metals, ceramics. Nowadays, we have the metal rapid prototype machines also, where we can use the small granules of metallic powder so that we can develop the RPT model. So in the material may be in the form of liquid or in the form of powder. Okay. Then the applications. You can see applications. So RPT is having so many applications, that is a wide range of applications, that is aerospace applications, automotive, biomedical applications, biomedical consumer product industries. So it is having high demand in these areas. Aerospace, if you see the Bangalore, that is HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, they are running the three projects. One is light combat aircraft, advanced light helicopter, unmanned vehicle, okay, UMV. Under these, so they developed nearly 30 to 40% of the components they developed using the rapid prototyping. Other remaining by machining of CNC machining and conventional machining and other processes. Minimum 30 to 40% they have developed the parts using the RPT technique. And even automotive industry also, there is a large demand for the RPT process, and biomedical applications, dental application, then orthopedic applications, we are using this RPT. And these are the some applications. Now the methods. Methods I just now explained to you, there are two kind of three or six methods are there. That is selective laser sintering, stereolithography, fused deposition modeling, laminated object manufacturing, 3D printing, inkjet. So there are six kind of techniques. Here, this slide shows about the main, what is the requirement and what is the minimum required to make a rapid prototype model. Okay. So that is design part CAD. You can use any CAD tool. You can develop a product. Okay. That is 3D model you have developed. Take that data in the form of IGS file or STL file. STL file stands for, that is standard triangular language file. And IGS stands for initial graphics exchange specification. Whenever you do the part modeling or assembly modeling, any drafting on the CAD, so you have some translators. So that those translator can be imported into another software. And after importing, you do the you can do the rest of the thing for through that software, particular software. So anybody, any person, he is not perfect in the full auto, any one software. So he may complete 50% of the work and he will give that data to the another software person. He will do the remaining thing. So like that, it is a, we can send the file, STL file or IGS file to the vendor. Then after getting this CAD file, and you have to build a prototype using different, you choose any selection by liquid process, by solid process, and by this powder metal. There are three kind of input material. One is powder. So second one is liquid and third one is solid. So particular pick any kind of material and you can go for the further RPT process. If you compare the CNC machining and this RPT machine, what is the difference is that is CNC machining mein kya, you can take the CAD software help, then CAM software. This CAM software will generate a G-codes. Whatever you are giving the machining parameters and like feed, speed, depth of cut, and a retract plane, tool material, tool angle, tool material, and all the machining parameters, feed, speed, depth of cut. And after selecting the machine, whether you have to select the CNC machine or you have to select the turning machine, according to that, that software will generate a particular product. It will generate a NC code, that is G codes as well as the generative. G stands for generative codes, which is which use the geometry of the component, like size of the component, dimension, length, breadth, depth. These are the dimension it will give. That's why it is called as generative code, which is also called as preparatory code. And in M codes, sir, it is the function of machine code. It controls the machine, like spindle on, spindle off, coolant on, coolant off. So like various, we can control using those code controls, we can control the CNC machine. Whereas the G code controls the geometry of the component, whether you want to have the size of the these are things. So once you get the this codes in the G and G codes and M codes, so that data will be fed to the CNC machine. So after that, the tool will cut the material, then you can get a final dimension of the product. Here the main thing is CAD software, the CAM software, you can get a here tool path generation will be there. After getting tool path generation, we can go for the machining. And then RPT, it is just somewhere, there is only just change in this design and all. These are designer, CAD software. Here we have the STL file. STLR, that is IGS file also. You have to first develop the model, you have to convert into STL file, then IGS file, then you can send it to the RPT machine, depending on the your particular process, whether you want to opt LOM or FDM, SLS, SLA, 3D printing, inkjet. So this is the just difference between the two steps between the CNC machining as well as the RPT machining. Then the normal advantages of RPT prototyping are, so that is the main advantages are, that is reduced product development time and cost. Main is reduction in time and the cost, reduction in cost also. Then get products to makers market soon. So there is a very quick products we can get through the RPT machines. If you compare CNC and conventional, so it is taking less amount of time to develop the product. And enhance communication between marketing, engineering, manufacturing, and purchasing. So it is a interrelated all the departments, like communication between the marketing people, engineering people, manufacturing, design, all these people. So there is a good coordination between all the departments. Then present physical model at critical design reviews. Then perform functional prototype testing before committing to tooling. So simple testing also can be possible in this. Generate precision production tooling. So these are the some advantages for the RPT. This is one kind of SGC, solid ground curing 5600, one RPT machine. It is a powder based. And you can see some of the components which we can develop, even the CNC also we can develop, and we can develop through the your RPT also. So this is, you can see the components. So this is one kind paper laminated object manufacturing method. This is a paper, and this is starch part made by the 3D printing process. The blue color ball shows the ball within a ball. So it is very complicated product. We cannot do machining in the even conventional and non-conventional. The only alternative method is to develop by the RPT process. Even we cannot develop in the non-traditional machining also this. Okay. And plaster part made by the 3DP process here. So the if you see the compare the aesthetics and if you compare the dimensions of the product, it is very good finer finishing products. And here the main another thing advantage is there is no secondary operations required for this. And these are the some ceramic parts. And if you take this, take the some scientific applications. So this is the man skull made by the 3DP process, and the same man skull made by the another. This is a SLS process. Anthropological model of skill model. This is a stereolithography process. So this is this product is made by the 3DP process. This is stereolithography, and we can use in the scientific applications also, and in molecular models also. So these kind of DNA structures, if you want to develop, it is very difficult in the CNC machining also. It is we cannot develop this kind of DNA structure prototype. So the only alternative is again this is RPT process. And this is DNA, deoxynucleic acid. It is developed by the FDM process. If you see this this critical object, it is not possible in CNC machining. And these are the molecular models and some other in medicine and dentistry also. In dental applications also for root canal treatment and this to get a sample size of the teeth, we can just scan the teeth and get the fabrication through the RPT process. In medicine and dentistry also, it is a huge demand. Even in orthopedics also, the bones, they are using for titanium alloys. So similarly, we can use this RPT process. RPT process to these bones, we can use in orthopedics. So this is my lecture plan. This is just I have given the overview of the RPT. My lecture plan for this rapid prototyping is first introduction and applications of CAD, because the main basic CAD fundamental is required to develop a prototype model. So the basic CAD, what kind of tools you are using, what kind of software you're using, what is the input data required for the RPT process, and what are the extensions files required for the RPT process. Thus, I will describe in this applications of CAD. Then fundamentals of CAD and CAM, how it is integrated, CAD CAM. Then introduction and applications of RPT, rapid prototyping. Then implementation of CAD-CAM in RPT. Then advances and what is the future scope in RPT. If you compare the present scenario, what is the future scope in RPT? So the computer, just I want to take the first computer-aided design. So the name itself is computer-aided design. The means it is a use of computer system to assist in creation, modification, analysis, or optimization of a design. And computer system include both hardware as well as the software to perform specialized design functions, this CAD. And computer-aided manufacturing is similarly, as we defined the computer-aided design, we can define the computer-aided manufacturing as use of computer systems to plan, manage, and control the operations of a manufacturing plant through either direct or indirect computer interface with the plant's production resources. So there is a, it is that word is using indirect computer interface. So there should be interface between the CAD as well as the CAM CNC machine, so that it can get the G codes and cut the material. So that's why integration of CAD CAM is very important in the CAD CAM. For the fundamentals of CAD, that is why we are going for the CAD. That is to increase the productivity of the designer, to improve the quality of design, to improve communication, to create a database for the manufacturing. So these are the some important parameters. Why do we select CAD process? And that is ICG system, interactive computer graphics, user-oriented system where computer is employed to create, transform, and display data in the form of pictures or symbols. Consists both hardware and software. If it is, it consists of the both hardware and hardware software, so that then only we can call it as interactive computer graphics. Now we will discuss the about simple the design process. How design process? First, recognition of need. What is the need of that particular product? First, you have to recognize the need. What is the need? Then second step is definition of problem. If you find out the need, then you can go for the definition of problem, where you can define the particular product, what is the use, why we are going to develop that product, and what is the need, all everything you display. The next is that is synthesis. Synthesis, the next one is analysis and optimization. After synthesis, the product and manufacturing, then you have to go for the analysis and optimization. Means whatever the parameters you are utilizing for optimizing the machining, any analysis parameters, you have to optimize. So that optimization is very important. And if your optimization and analysis is not in proper order, means it is not up to your level, up to the desired level. So it will come back to the synthesis again. You have to do the proper synthesis. Then again, it will feed it to the analysis and optimization. Then next, it goes to the next evaluation. Evaluation means that is presentable form. Okay. After optimization, you can evaluate the results. So that evaluation results can be shown to the vendor. And if for evolution, that is evolution process is not up to the mark, again, it will go back to the again synthesis. If your synthesis is not proper, means you will not get the accurate results of optimization as well as the evaluation. The next, that is presentation. After your evaluation is okay, then you can present to the vendors. So, so these are the six parameters which we can design the for the design process. That is recognition of need, definition of problem, synthesis, analysis, optimization, evaluation, and presentation. So these are the some application of computer science design. Simply, I will go briefly. Geometric modeling, engineering analysis, design review and evaluation, automated drafting. In geometric modeling, that is, now these four applications of computer science design, which we can club with the design compute CAD process. So now we can see that recognition of need, definition of problem, synthesis, optimization, evaluation, presentation, how it is interrelated with the computers. So geometric modeling, in geometric modeling only, you can get all the recognition of need, definition of problem, synthesis, all the. Next, this analysis or optimization gives the engineering analysis. Under engineering analysis, we can go for the analysis and optimization. And the third one is design review and evaluation. You can review the design status and evaluation. Then next, that is automated drafting. So these four color, which shows yellow in color. So those are geometric modeling, engineering analysis, design review and evaluation. Then next is automated drafting. Once you compare, complete these full flowchart with these four basics of the Shingle process, then it is called your totally design process. This is about the, so these six elements are Shingle's design process, and these four elements are computers in design, how you are using the computer efficiently using in the system. So geometric modeling, that is the main basic thing, is designer constructs the graphical image on the screen of the ICG system. Construction includes creation of the geometric entities, modification, display, storing the data file. Okay, storing is the data file. And geometric model, again, we have two kind of modeling, that is 2D model and 3D model. We can go for the 2D modeling as well as the 3D modeling. And again, 3D model is, that is, again, we have three kind of modeling, that is wireframe model, surface model, third one is your solid model. Okay. And then applications of CAM is, that is computer monitoring control applications, manufacturing support applications. So computer monitoring controller, that is computer, and this is a process. The process data is only one directional here. It is, if you see the lower picture, that is computer process, it is a bidirectional. Okay, computer, and it is sending the control signals to the process. Process is sending the process data to the computer. It is a vice versa. So it is a complete circle is there. Okay, whereas in the first picture, that is only unidirectional. Computers, the process is sending the data to the computer. And manufacturing support applications are, so numerical control programming, computer automated process planning, computer generated work standards, production scheduling, shop floor control, all comes under the manufacturing support onto computer-aided manufacturing applications. And the product cycle and CAM, CAD CAM. The ancient product cycle is, that is, first customers and market need. He has to see the customer's need and market. What is the kind of design, what is kind of data required for the vendors. Next, once you decide the customer's desireness, you can develop the product concept. Any product you want to develop, first you have to analyze the product, whether it is suitable or not, whether it is useful for the benefit to the customers or not, you have to check. Second, that is design engineering. After the concept is designed, okay, After the concept is okay, then we have to go for the design engineering. That is design engineering. Next, drafting. So he'll draft the particular CAD data or drawing dimensions. Then process planning. Process planning. Then next is production scheduling. And scheduling after production. If scheduling is required, after production scheduling, you can go for the productions. That is weekly basis, hourly basis, monthly basis, like batch production, mass production, all this. Then after getting the production products from the production center, then you can go for the quality control, whether it is a quality checked or not. If your quality control if rejects the component, again you have to come to the production department. Again you have to rectify the particular dimension, any size, the shape, anything. Again you have to maintain the design dimensions. Again you have to give to the quality. If quality control says okay, then it will go to the customers market after dispatching section. So this is the white color block shows you, this is your only traditional machining. How these are integrated with the CAD/CAM, that I want to go with now. How these traditional product cycle is integrated with your CAD/CAM cycle. So computer-aided design, you can see computer-aided design. Here, by using these two departments, we can develop one computer-aided design. Okay, one department can manage design concept as well as the design engineering. Then second is drafting. Drafting department is, computer automated drafting and documentation. The next is, that is computer aided process planning. We can, in this you can go for the computer process planning, scheduling, all these things. The next computerized scheduling, MRP, that is material requirement planning, shop floor control. So these are all the considered as another department. And after that, that is computer controlled robots and machine, where we are using in the shop floor, that is computer controlled robots, machine. That is computer aided quality control. In computer aided quality control, those are, we can use some coordinate measuring machines, digitizers, scanners to check the dimensions of the particular product. So this is the yellow part, yellow rectangular block shows your integration of CAD/CAM cycle with the traditional cycle. So the white color shows simple traditional cycle, and the yellow color rectangular block shows your computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing cycle. How these can be integrated? CAM automations are, that is automation achievements are, that is earlier it was numerical control, after so many years we have got direct numerical control, then computer numerical control, machine vision, and robots are replacing all shop floors. There is no human in the shop floor. All things were replaced by the robots in arc welding and stamp welding, sheet metal welding, parts handling, all these things. Computer integrated manufacturing systems, numerical control, computer numerical control. So this is about the CAM automation. If you see this design tools, with the help of design tools and we can CAD tools, we can make the computer with the help of hardware and software. And if you see this these three circles diagram, so computer graphics concept, if you are giving the definition about the computer design, computer graphics concept, geometric modeling is there, design tools, that is analysis codes, heuristic, etc. So this is about the CAD tool. And CAM tools, if you think about the CAM tools, that is networking concepts, CAD and manufacturing tools, what kind of manufacturing processes and what kind of tools we are using to develop a manufacturing model. And if you integrate these two, CAD tools as well as the CAM tools, so this is the final chart we are getting with the help of CAD as well as the CAM tools. That is manufacturing tools, design tools, geometric modeling, computer graphics, then networking integration of concept. Then when you are thinking about the CAD/CAM tools, there should be a proper integration between the CAD as well as the CAM. Hardware required are, that is CISC-based and RISC-based. That is CISC-based as Intel, AMD, Motorola. Normally we go for the CISC-based hardware only. RISC-based are SunSpec, DEC, IBM, all these. Advanced input devices and outputs devices, storage devices. These are the all hardwares. And what kind of software required to run these softwares? Normally, you should have the good operating system, that is Windows, like Windows, Windows 8, Windows 9, Windows 10, Windows Vista, all these things. And sometimes you can go for the even Unix application, like Red Hat and Unix, all these operating systems. And application software is, well, that is application software. There are various kinds of softwares. That is SolidWorks, Ideas, Catia. So there are various softwares available to run this software. Solid AutoCAD, MDT Inventor. So this is the AutoCAD MDT Inventor is a free software which we can be downloaded from AICTE website. So this is a free software for all the technical institutions where AICTE is giving a free license. That is AutoCAD you can run, you can MDT. MDT stands for Mechanical Desktop and Inventor. These three softwares you can run with the free license software. Then SolidWorks, SolidAids, Ideas. Ideas stands for that is Integrated Design Engineering Analysis Specification Software, shortly. And CATIA is that is Computer Aided Three-Dimensional Integrated Application. CATIA. Then Uni Graphics Pro Engineering. Now, right now, ProE, we have the ProE Creo version, latest version. And where other softwares are available also. Now, the standards. Standards are also required. The CAD standards are required to import and export the CAD data from various softwares. So that's why these CAD standards are required. So any data, if you want to import, you should be convert into the STL file or IGS file so that you can import and you can give it to the other software with those extension files. So with the help of those translators, we can import and export the CAD models. So different kind of standards are graphical kernel system, and PHIGS, that is called Programmers Hierarchical Interface for Graphics, Core, GKS, that is Graphical Kernel System, IGS, this is the main standard, CAD standard, Initial Graphic Exchange Specification. BXF is, that is Drawing Exchange Format. Then STEP, it is also one kind of standard in CAD. Standard for Exchange of Product Model Data. Then DMS, Dimensional Measurement Interface Specification. VDI, Virtual Device Interface. VDM, Virtual Device Metafile. And GKS, and that is GKS Metafile. These are the some various for compatibility, portability, for proper interfacing at various levels. Normally, we do go for the GKS and as well as the IGS and STEP. These are the standards, that is GKS, IGS, and STEP. So various standards, you can see the in graphics database, that is DXF, IGS, STEP files are there, application program, GKS, PHIGS, Core, and graphics function, that is VDI, VDM, NAPLOPS. So these are the various standards in graphics programming. Now, 2D geometric modeling of a box. So this is the simple geometric modeling, okay? This is just simple 2D geometric modeling, that is wireframe modeling. Now, second one is that is surface modeling. Okay, only surfaces are taking. This is surface modeling. The last one is that is a geometric modeling. That is geometric modeling is 3D model. Okay. Now, this is the basic three models, surface modeling, solid modeling, as well as the, this is 3D model, solid model. And under this, we have two kind of techniques, that is constructive solid geometry. It is shortly called as CREP, that is constructive solid geometry. The next one is that is boundary representation method, BREP, that is boundary representation method. Normally, we go for the constructive solid geometry only to develop that, to build a model. Okay. In the boundary representation, only the boundaries of surface, that is edges, are used to define a surface. Only the edges only. Okay. And the surface's elements are assembled to form at an airtight boundary, thus making a solid model. Okay, engineering analysis is, that is, after designing, we can go for the engineering analysis. In analysis, we can see the analysis of the product, calculation of mass properties and mechanical properties, finite element method, finite value method, stress analysis. In stress analysis, we can see the stress distribution in particular product and the deflection, how the deflection occurs in that product. We can see stress analysis, thermal analysis, dynamic and coupled field analysis. These are various kind of analysis. You can go through the ANSYS software, NISA, NASTRON, NISA, IDINA, all these softwares. Then the third one is design review and evaluation. In this, we can go for the tolerance analysis and interference checking in assembly, kinematic assembly motion study, automated drafting. The last one is under that shingless design. The last one is automated drafting, that is creation of hard copy engineering drawing. Creation of hard copy engineering drawings, dimensioning, generation of cross hatched area, scalings. Whatever we do in the through mini drafter, whatever the drawings we are doing, the same kind of drawings can be done by the using the software, that is AutoCAD or MDT, Inventor, all softwares. We can develop the sectional views, enlarged views and cross-hatched views, development of orthogonal views, development of isometric views also possible. Now the benefits, if you want to see the benefits of CAD, that is improved engineering productivity, the productivity improved, we can see the productivity. Second is shorter lead time. In the small amount of time, we can develop a product. Customer modifications are easier to make. You can go for the modification. Whenever we require some modification needed, you can go for the modifying the part. We can improve accuracy in design, fewer errors in design and manufacturing. There are, if you find out that you can find very small amount of errors in design and manufacturing. Better inspection of complicated parts. Reduce prototype testing. So these are the some benefits. Now the part computer aided design part is over. Now CAM. CAM, we can see the computer manufacturing. It is consists of NC, CNC machines, robotics, CAM software. What are the CAM softwares? There are various like Master CAM, Gibbs CAM, Surf CAM, Dell CAM, okay, Pro Manufacturing, your Ideas Manufacturing, Katia Manufacturing, all these softwares we have. And in this virtual manufacturing, we can see the virtually, we can see the simulation of the particular tool during the machining. So virtual machining is, we can see online inspection of CMM, that is coordinate measuring machine. We can go for the online inspection. CNC with RPT machines and CNC with reverse. Now the trend is CNCs we are using with the help of RPT machines to get a final this one. CNC with RPT machines, CNC with reverse engineering. RPT machines are, you know, rapid prototyping machines. Reverse engineering is, we are going reverse engineering approach. First selecting the main, you have to take the master component, you have to scan the component using digitizer scanners, then you can develop the cloud points, then you can generate a geometry. This is a reverse, that's why it is called reverse engineering. Starting from the final product, we are developing the product. So that's why it is called reverse engineering. And some terminologies are used in the computer manufacturing, that is numerical control, some computer numerical control, direct numerical control, flexible manufacturing cell, FMS system. We have very good FMS system in our lab. We can, and finally, you can see our lab also. We have a sophisticated lab about the flexible manufacturing system, computer integrated manufacturing, computer design. These are the some terms used in the CNC. It is a programmable automation in which the machining process is controlled by the numericals, numbers, and letters and symbols. Like numbers are from 0 to 9, letters from A to Z, and symbols like we have the dollar symbol, then percentage symbol and at the rate symbol. We can have different kind of symbols. It is simply a programmable automation in which the machining process is controlled by the numericals, that is numericals and your kind of letters as well as your symbols. Now you can see this earlier in NC and S, and if you go back about four to five decades back, we were using paper tape and that paper tape is it is a machining code actually, paper tape, and we are feeding to the machine control unit MCU. From that, the data is transferring to the NC machine, numerical control, whether it may be the turning machine or whether it may be the milling machine. After that CNC machine, we had CNC machines. NC machines, after NC machines, there are a large development in the CNC machines. Here, we are using the controllers, computer and controllers. Through the computer, we are giving the data to the controller, and controller is giving the data to the CNC machines. Either it may be the CNC turning machine or milling machine, according to your design concept. Now the DNC, that is direct numerical control, also it is called as distributed numerical control, which transfer the data from the host computer to the number of various machines. So from the host computer, it is transferring the same data to the n number of machines. So that's how it is NC machines. And if we are using the term distributed numerical control, then the same, we are using the from host data, host computer, we are transferring the data to the various number of N machines, CNC machines. Okay. In earlier case, we have the NC machine. The data is transferring to the various NC machines. And here the data is transferring to the various CNC machines. That is distributed numerical control. To save a time only, so we have this kind of DNC controls. Now the CNC machining center. CNC machining center means it is a combination of all machining processes like drilling, boring, milling, tapping, all these various kind of machining process. If you perform in one CNC machine, then it is called CNC machining center. CNC machining centers are a kind of CNC machine that can perform drilling, boring, milling, tapping, etc. and multi-axis control with tool magazine containing variety of tools to perform various machining operations. So we are using here minimum as a three-axis machine, minimum three-axis for the CNC milling, minimum two-axis for the CNC turning. And we have up to the five-axis machining also, okay. So this portion shows, this is a three-axis machine. X is a linear, Y is also linear movement, Z is your tool movement, okay. If you take this X, this is Y, this is X, this is Y, and Z is tool movement. This is X movement, okay, linear movement, and Y this movement, and Z is tool movement, that is a retract plane. Z is a plane. So if you have another, these are the three linear axes, it is called three-axis machine. If you have two rotational axes about the X-axis, Y-axis, then it is called as your five-axis machine. Three linear axes, two rotational axes. Altogether, it is called five-axis machine. And here we can see the vertical machining center. We have the vertical tool. Okay, vertical machining center, vertical tool. And horizontal machine, we have the tool spindle is horizontally tool. Okay. So that is the brief picture about the CNC machining center. So normally we use only the three machines. If you want to go for any kind of complicated objects like turbine blades, impellers, any kind of complicated objects, you can go for the five-axis machine, where we have the total five axes, three linear axes, two rotational axes. So the methods of CNC programs are manual part programming and computer part programming. Manual part programming, kya? Just it is a simply conventional APT program, is this advanced programming tool. And computer part programming, we have the you have to use the softwares. First, you have to generate a solid model. You have to give the machining parameters to the product. It will cut the material and it will generate a toolpath generation. Then after getting toolpath generation, we have to feed that data to the CNC machine. It will cut the material. Then post-processing is required. Post-processing are required to convert your simple machine data to the NC codes, N and G codes. That is numerical control codes that are G codes as well as the M codes. And finally, there is a process verification. Under verification, you can see the how much material is being removed from the workpiece, and how the tool is coming and cutting the material. So everything we can observe, that is called verification. There are various softwares. VeriCut is one of the huge demand software, where we can see the tool path generation, numerical control check also we can possible. So this is about the various axes. And computer aided manufacturing, first the minimum data is that is CAD model, manufacturing model, it will generate the tool definition, raw material definition, workpiece geometry definition, cutting parameters you have to give. Then it will give the tool path generation. Then you have to send the data to the computer data to the post processing machine. Then it will give to the NC code, that is G code, SEM code, it will give. That data should be fed to your NC machine. This is the total flow chart about the CAM. CAD model, manufacturing model, tool definition. That is tool definition, raw material definition, workpiece geometry, cutting parameters you are giving, tool path generation, post processing, and NC code. This is the overview of the total computer-aided manufacturing. So how, starting from the CAD design, how you are developing the part through CAM softwares. It is integration of CAD as well as the CAM. And you can see this now, computer-aided manufacturing with the these, you can see the with pictorial diagrams. That is CAD model. First step is CAD model. You have to generate a CAD model using the CAD software. So this is a CAD model. It is an example of turbine blade. Okay. Then the tool path generation. The green color shows you the workpiece. And the tool is red color. You can see here, the red color is a tool. Okay. Second step is tool. You have to define the tool. First is you have to generate a CAD model. Second, you have to give the tool definition. Then third one is raw material definition. Okay. Raw material boundary. Then workpiece geometry definition. Workpiece geometry. The fourth step is for workpiece geometry. The next, cutting parameters. So this is the one of the essential parameters, essential thing in the CAM process. That is, you have to give the cutting parameters like feed, speed, depth of cut, and all these parameters. Once you give the proper, all these cutting parameters, then the tool will cut the material virtually. Tool path generation. It will give the tool path. The next one is, after getting the tool path generation, you can see in the virtual reality, you can see how much material is being removed and how the tool is retracting to the Z plane and how it is going X axis, Y axis. Then it is touching to the workpiece and cutting the material. Everything virtually you can see the in tool path generation. After that is numerical control check is there. You can verify the with the help of that numerical control check. You can see how much material is being removed and how much still have to be removed from the workpiece. Everything it is visualized. So here the post processing is required. Tool path generation CLS file. It is also called as cutter location specification file. So conversion of this data to the G codes is called post processing. Post processing, the main aim of post processing is to convert the tool path generation, that is CLS file, into your G codes, M codes. So if you feed these tool path generation file directly to the machine data file, so the machine will not read this data because it will not understand the CLS file. It will understand only the G codes and M codes. Okay. And it will, after post processing, we can send the data to the CNC machine. Okay, these are some virtual manufacturing. So the commercially softwares available are, you can see the IDEAS, UGCAM, SmartCAM, MasterCAM, ProE. So these are the various CAM softwares and tooling for CNC machines. Okay, this is a coordinate measuring machine with the help of these probes. With the help of these probes, there are totally five probes up there, left, right, and left. This is left and right, and one bottom. Okay, so these probes are there where we can. Here you can see this picture that is coordinate measuring machine. With the help of this probe, we can go for the dimensioning the other products. We can check, that is called computer control quality check. And you can see the gantry type, very bigger size CMM coordinate measuring machines. Through the help of this probe, again, we can scan, we can surfacely, so that we can get the body layer of the automobile. And these are called, since it is a very huge gantry type, it is called as a gantry type coordinate measuring machines. We have sometimes portable CMM machines also. We can take that portable CMM machine, go to the vendor site, and you can inspect the component at vendor site. So that's why it should be very handy. Okay, that is portable CMM machine. When go to vendor site, and you can check the particular product. These are the, you can see, these are the Faro arm portable CMM machine. With the help of this handy portable, we can go to the vendor side and check the particular components which we require. And CNC machines as inspection tool. Okay, this is also, tool is replaced with the tool probe for inspection. In place of tool, we are using the probes, and the, through the probes, again, we can check the particular component geometry like that. The CNC machine has inspection tool. This is also one kind of. And you can see this is the die is under inspection at VMC, that is vertical machining center. So the it is having some cavity, and it is through this probe, you can check particular dimensions. What is the length? What is the radius? What is the depth is there? And you can check all the designs. Yeah, this is a brief flowchart about the CAM. First, a design model, and you have to select proper workpiece, manufacturing model. Then you have to set up the database here. Set up database. You have to select the machine tool. Depending on your product design, you have to select which kind of CNC machine, milling or turning you have to select. You have to give the setup operation, define NC sequences. Like according to your design concept, you can give the sequences. Suppose for milling, you can go for the value milling, then pocketing, drilling, all this. For turning operation, you can go for the facing, step turning, knurling, threading, these kind of operations, and you can go. Once you get these different sequences, you can get cutter location data in the form of APT, that is advanced programming tool. Then again, you have to go for the post-processing. And finally, you can convert the NC data, which is in the form of C codes and N codes. Okay, this is about the CAM. And these are the CAD CAM used in mold making. So these are the some mold injection mold dies. The product is helmet. Through injection molding, you can develop these kind of helmet products. And this is the dies. The dies were machined using the CAD CAM software. So the impression, you can see the inside cavity, upper die, lower die, everything can be machined by using the CAD CAM software. And this is a one kind of CMM, coordinate measuring machine. This is CNC lathe, this is CNC turning lathe. This is 5-axis machine. Okay, here X, Y, Z are the three linear axes. Okay, and these two rotational axes, A and B, B will rotate along the Y axis, A will rotate along the X axis. Okay, here Z is linear moment. Okay, here Y axis is shown as your retract plane. Y, this is X, this is Z. Now you can go for the rapid prototyping. Rapid prototyping is a technology which uses digital data to construct models, prototypes by layer by layer. Since it is constructing layer by layer, so that's why it is also called as layer manufacturing method. And another method is additive manufacturing process, layer manufacturing method, and rapid prototyping. One are all the same. The creation of the model prototype begins with a solid model designed using a CAD software. The minimum basic requirement is CAD software. The different CAD softwares are ProEngineer, CATIA, Unigraphics, IDEA, SolidWorks, and SolidEdge, everything. You can see in this slide, you can see that is the such system also known by the general names, that is freeform fabrication, solid freeform fabrication, layered manufacturing. Normally, the terminology used as layered manufacturing. So there are various kind of techniques, that is laminated object manufacturing, stereolithography, selective laser sintering, 3D printing, inkjet, fused deposition modeling, all these six kind of techniques. Normally, out of all these six, the major method using was laminated object manufacturing, fused deposition modeling. That is the main thing is that it is a combination of two technologies allows the rapid generation to accurate prototype products, the development of new products more quickly and more efficiently. So there is no secondary operations. You have exact dimension you will get finally, and no error, and accuracy is 100% accuracy is there in this product. The aim of RP is to generate the accurate prototype parts in the correct material to form, fit, and function the testing. Then what are rapid prototyping technologies? Just now I highlighted the various kind of rapid prototype technologies are, that is, rapid prototype process are a relatively recent development. The first machine was released into the market in late 1987. And different different process of RPR, stereolithography, laser sintering, fused deposition modeling, solid ground curing, laminate object manufacturing. Apart from these six methods, other addition processes are ballistic particle manufacturing and three-dimensional printing. Rapid prototyping processes are driven by instructions which are derived from three-dimensional computer-aided data. CAD technologies are therefore an essential enabling system for rapid prototyping. And the processes work by using lasers to cut and sinter material into a layer. Main thing is we are using lasers here, okay? Many different materials like thermopolymers, photopolymers, other plastics, paper, wax, metallic powder, etc. are used. And some strategic importance of rapid prototyping technologies are, what is the main strategic importance of rapid prototyping technology? So that is, rapid prototyping is the only solution to every part fabrication problem. If the requirement involves prototyping a complex geometry part, RP has the advantage. If you want to go any complex geometry, RPT is the best solution. Surgeons, architects, artists, and individuals from many other disciplines also routinely using this technology. Even if you go for the orthopedic application, orthopedic dentist, orthopedician and dentist, and surgeons, we have this technology. The materials used in rapid prototyping are limited and dependent on the method chosen. So it mainly differs with which kind of method you are choosing to develop the product. Choosing the method, you have to select the your input material. Okay, these are the, and here there are secondary processes are available to convert pattern made into rapid prototype process to final materials or tools. Now the question arises, do we really need RP? Do we have other choices? Do we really need RPT means? Yes, of course, we do require RPT processes. Do we have other choices? Other than, still if you have more complexity, you have any other sources, other technology to machine that product? No, because this is the only highest alternative way to develop the any kind of complexity of the product. So only the alternative solution is RP. There is no technology other than this RPT to develop the complexity of the product. And what are the limitations? Because as you said, you were asking about the limitations. Limitation is again, it is depending on the size. Wow, what kind of size you are developing through the CAD, the size depends. If you are having the bigger size, you have to effort for the bigger size machine. So the cost also, as you are increasing the dimension of the object, again, you will increase the, obviously it will increase the amount of your fabrication of your RPT machine also. So the size limits. So we have some limited size to develop this product. And sometimes limitations is here stair stepping. That is stair stepping means some protruded portion in that particular product. Like in the excess material, if you go for the forging, after making the forging component, we have some excess material. That excess material has to be removed. The excess material is called as flash. In the same way here, the terminology, the excess material, protruded material is called as stair stepping. So to avoid stair stepping, again, we take that particular component to the grinding operation. In front of grinding, we can remove that protruded portion so that you can get a finer smooth surface. And here you can see the stair stepping. You can see this protruded portion. This protruded portion can be removed using the grinding operation. And here you can see these some protruded green color occurs here. So that can be removed again with smaller grinding tools. And here also you can see stepping. Here some protruded portion. Here also you can see some dots are there that can be smoothened using the your stair operation, stair stepping. How complex does a geometry have to be required rapid prototyping? So there is how complex does a geometry have means any kind of complexity of the project it can have and it can do for the RPT. So these are the some complex compound shapes are best fabricated using the RPT products. These are using RPT. Small desktop milling machines. Materials also we can use like plastic material, other materials like ceramics, paper, plaster, starch, foundry parts. You can see the engineering ceramic parts. They are made by the various techniques, 3D printing, LOM, laminar object manufacturing, and scientific applications. These two manuscripts are made by the 3DP process and SLS process. And these molecular models like DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, it is made by the shape itself is a very complicated. This kind of product can be developed by the FDM process. In medicine and medicines and dentistry and orthopedic applications also, you can use this. Okay, these are the some components developed by the product. So this is one kind of Guinness record in the rapid tool creation. So you can see the dimension, that is 740 by 500 into 60 mm. 740 length, 500 breadth, 60 mm thickness. So this kind of final product can be achieved with this in the RPT machine using the 3DP process. These are the some various benefits in the RPT technology. So this is a pictorial view. Okay, why 3D? For any kind of this RPT, CNC, and anything, the 3D CAD model is required. CAD CAM, like for mold design, for mold designs, okay, molds, dies design, 3D model is required. For CNC machine, 3D model is required. Rapid prototyping, 3D model is required. Reverse engineering, 3D model is required. Finite element method, finite element difference method, FEA, 3D model is required. Tooling design, drafting, for all these minimum, that is input material is the 3D model. After making 3D model only, you can go for the mold design, CNC machine, and RPT, reverse engineering, FEA, all these techniques. Okay. So these are the various RP processes. Wide material choices have led to, there are various kind of RPT processes. You can see all these developed by stereolithography, these products, and thermojet, selective laser sintering, fusion deposition modeling, 3D printing. So you can see this bottom, totally five techniques are there: stereolithography, thermojet process, selective laser sintering, fusion deposition modeling, and 3D printing. So these are the techniques we can develop the products, like in avionics, in automobile, and in engines, and in ceramic parts, plastic parts, you can develop all this. So you can see the applications in matrix feasibility. Selective laser sintering, fusion deposition modeling, thermojet, DMLS, other process. You can go for the design communication, casting, prototyping, prototyping tooling, stress analysis. The number of users are main thing is gas turbine users, UAV, combat aircraft, missiles, battle tanks, sensors. In this area, normally, moreover, in DRDO, in CSIR labs, they are more they are using highly these RPT process. They are using highly. For the gas turbine, you know, one Bangalore GTRE, Gas Turbine Research Establishment, one of the DRDO lab, they are using this CAD CAM, RPT, even in HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Bangalore, in engine division, as well as the helicopter division, they are using this. And GTRE and ADA, Aeronautical Development Agency, is there. In the Aeronautical Development Agency lab, they are using these software RPT, and they are using high-end CAD CAM software like CAD CAM, like ANSYS software, ANSYS, NISA, Nastron, IDINA, NISA, EEL, these are high softwares they are using. In educational, in educational institutions, we are using only educational version on softwares only we are using. So these are the some products developed by the RPT process. And you can see these are all some. This is the DRDL model, a NASA model they made. Okay, these are the some product developed by the RPT process. Okay, this Saras aircraft, they developed this model for RP model of control wheel. Okay. You can see this laser engineering net shaping. This is also one kind of technique, laser engineered net shaping. We can develop the design the product, CAD solid model, slice model, layer additive fluid. Then this is the process, which kind of process you are using. Then the part. Finally, you can develop this kind of part layer by layer. So you can, the process may be, it may be the fusion deposition modeling, it may be the selective laser sintering, it may be the stereolithography, it may be 3D printing, any kind of technique.
And more, if you see this picture, here the maximum are DRDO, profile of RP users in the country are, the maximum amount is DRDO labs. They are using 30% DRDO labs are using. 30% this and four-wheeler, this 30% four-wheeler automobile industries. Maximum 60% is covered by DRDO labs and your CSR labs as well as, and remaining 30% covered by your four-wheeler automobile manufacturers. And the rest of the users are public sector units, and engineering academica institutions, service bureau, medical applications, electronics, these are the things. So this, the same product was developed by SLA process, LOM process, FDM, and wooden process, simple. So it is the comparative statement of the design of the using various processes, selective laser sintering, and stereolithography, laminate object manufacturing, FDM, and wooden. In knee joint also, this knee joint through the, again, RPT, they designed through the RPT process. Using the CAD software, they designed that femur, and then they developed through the this is also same thing, knee joint. You can see the knee joint replacement, you can see. So whatever they produced through this RPT process, they're replacing in the human body. Okay. This is the reversing process, cloud data. After getting the cloud data, you can generate a solid model, then go for the solid model, surface model, solid model. This is one kind of reverse engineering. First getting a cloud data from the master component, then make the surface modeling, then go for the solid modeling. So this is the CAD solid model, exploded view of this particular processes assembly, knee joint. The stress analysis also they performed through the ANSYS software. So this is the something finally. This is about RPT. There's just overview of RPT processes.